Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Manor House Church, home of Portland Bible College, and of the graduating class of 2022. Pastor Mark Estes, the Board of Elders and the Board of Directors welcome you this evening. And before we begin, we'd like to remind you to silence your cell phones, find your seat. We'll begin shortly. Thank you.
Don't they look good tonight? All right, we just want to welcome you. And first, I just want to give a shout out to everybody that's watching streaming. We actually have people all over the world watching now. We have a number of online students graduating that couldn't be here tonight. So I want to give a shout out to you, Georgette over in Holland. We've got Ben in Virginia, all the rest of you. Just want to thank you for joining us. And hopefully you can just feel like you're right in the room with us. Come on, let's give everybody a hand that's not even actually here that's tuning in. I also want to just mention and give a shout out. You know, we have a lot of different programs here, and one of ours is to have affiliate programs where other churches will host like mini Bible colleges. And I know we've got a whole group here from our affiliate over in Boise, Idaho, right down here. Let's give them a hand. We got, right across here. Thanks for being here. All right. So this is going to be an interesting evening because it's really special. Yes, it's an official graduation ceremony. We're going to do it right. We're going to hand out degrees, etc. But this is also like a spiritual party, you know? And so what we're going to do to start with is I'm going to ask you all to stand. I'm going to kind of just open in prayer. And then we're going to invite you to come into PBC Chapel. We're just going to worship together, because this is all about the Lord's hand upon each one of these young people's lives and how he's working in their life. And we're celebrating that tonight. So let's pray together. Lord, we are so grateful for your presence in each life here. And Lord, tonight, even as we celebrate the amazing things you're doing in each one of these students' lives, and Lord, for the last 2 and 4 years, and how your hand has been so evident upon them, Lord, and how they're growing and learning in so many ways. And Lord, there's just so many ways you have proven yourself to be just so faithful. And Lord, right now in your presence, we invite your presence tonight. We do this to honor you, to honor your purpose for each life here, Lord, as they surrender and follow your path. So Lord, just bless this time now. Bless them as they receive this. Everyone that's here and watching online, we thank you for your presence. In your name we pray. Remain standing and we're going to worship together. Welcome to chapel. Someone who's on the stage here, and you right now would want to thank the Lord for his goodness and faithfulness in their lives. Come on, let's thank the Lord. Let's thank him together. Amen. Amen. Thank you, worship team. Thank you. You can be seated. Amen. Nothing like it, worshiping together with young hearts that are on fire for God. We're going to move right into awarding degrees at this time. So we're actually going to prepare to award our associate's degrees. These are the two-year degrees. So I'm going to have all those receiving associate's degrees. Would you please stand? And here we go.
Associate of Theology, Janisha Anderson, summa cum laude.
That's awesome.
Ian Chavez.
That's awesome. Great job, buddy.
Elin Collins.
Let's go. Come on. That's so awesome.
David Dolan.
Come on, buddy. Great job, man.
Camila Forbin.
Congratulations. Great job.
Landon Grimm, summa cum laude.
Let's go, buddy.
Clayton Hackett. Isaac Hitlett, summa cum laude.
Come on, man. Congrats, bud. Great job, man.
John Jay.
Come on, man. Great job, bud. Let's go. Come on.
Priscilla Jensen.
Congratulations.
Ali Kane, summa cum laude.
Congratulations.
Caleb Kimboy.
Let's go. Come on, congrats. Great job, buddy.
Shannon LaFrambois.
Oh, here we go. Congratulations.
Christina Luna.
Congratulations. So good. Come on.
Kaylin Makarov, cum laude.
Come on, man. Congrats.
Caleb McCracken, magna cum laude.
Come on, man. Congrats.
Quentin McLean, cum cum laude.
Come on, man. Congratulations, man.
Abigail Mold, magna cum laude.
Congratulations. Great job. Great job.
Obed Palacios.
Come on, man. Congrats.
Danielle Proctor.
Hey, there we go. Go California. Let's go.
Suriel Ramirez.
Come on, man. Great job, bud. Great job.
Gabriela Smith, summa cum laude.
Congratulations. Great job.
Caleb Stutzman.
Come on, bud. Great job, buddy.
Kobe Trejo.
Come on, man. Let's go, buddy.
Associate of Church Music, Christiana Seagraves.
Come on, congratulations.
Natalia Torres, cum laude.
Great job. Congratulations.
Associate of Christian Humanities, Brenna Baer.
Congratulations, great job.
Ariana Jaquith, summa cum laude.
Hey, here we go, come on, congratulations.
Associate of Church Leadership, Benjamin Allworth.
All right, here we go. All right, let's give them all one big hand. Okay, guys. Turn the tassels. Here you go. Congrats. Yeah, good job. All right. You can be seated. Thank you. All right. I want to just share a couple of things with you before we move on and award the bachelor's degree. This class that we just presented, associate's degree to, obviously that's a two-year program. Can anybody remember what was going on in your world 2 years ago? You know, 2 years ago this spring, you know, like the world comes to a halt, and halfway through our semester, you know, we had to switch to virtual, which had to happen in a lot of places. I really want to give a shout out right now to the faculty and staff of Portland Bible College who heroically pulled that off. Would you all stand right now? Let's have all the faculty and staff of PBC stand right here. Give them a hand. So worthy. So worthy. These are the best people I know. They're an amazing team to work with, and they dedicate their lives, their time, their energy. Everybody goes beyond the call of duty, and it was certainly tested that spring. But we did it, and we finished that semester. And then that fall of 2020, we were the only college in Oregon that was totally in person all school year. And that's a credit. That's a credit to them, and it's a credit to our students who just so cooperated, and obviously we had to change how we did things, you know, to play it safe and all of that. And I don't know who we give the award to for who was in quarantine the most times. Okay, there's a debate over that, but anyway. But our faculty was able to, you know, we zoomed into the students in quarantine, and we had people in the classroom. We had to shift around for spacing, and so it was no regular school year. But those who just received the associates, they're such a special class in my heart, because they were the ones who that fall, when the world was still going crazy, they said, I don't care if the world's going crazy, I'm going to go full-time and prepare myself for the call of God on my life. And they came that fall, and guys, you did it. And you proved a lot of people wrong, and a lot of people in the world were just hiding out in fear, oh, we're all going to die, you know, and all of that. And you guys came, and you did it right, you did it well. And I just consider you just kind of the cream of the crop. You came just so ready to go, so dedicated, so open, so hungry. And it was hard to figure out who you are because you were all wearing masks all the time, you know. I hated that in the classroom, you know. But anyway, we got through all of that. And I just want you to know, you guys, you did something. It's like you helped PBC move forward when it was very difficult for schools to move forward. And it was your heart and passion and perseverance, and I'll never forget you. Love you for it. And all of our student body who did that. It was actually an amazing year. And then this last year, then, you know, our normal kind of size freshman class kind of bounced back because, you know, a lot of more people were thinking, okay, the coast is clear, we can do this. But would you just one more time just thank them for their dedication and perseverance? I just, you know, thank you. Thank you. And another thing that really has persevered through all, actually grown through this, is even though it took a dip that first year, but there's a variety of ways in which PBC serves the body of Christ, churches and students all over the world in different ways. And you know, we have the online program, and that really, that doubled that year in terms of our online students. And I think we've had around 300 students this year total between the two semesters. Not counting, we have an online program in Spanish. We have an online program in Portuguese. I mean, you could tell we even sang Spanish words tonight. You know, we're into different languages. And then we have a program for high school students that gets them grounded in the Word and biblical worldview and doctrine and personal growth and discipleship. And that's coming back strong now. In our affiliate program, we have 200 students in affiliate programs in different churches. And so I just want you to know that PBC, none of those things would happen if it wasn't for these people, because it's all out of what is happening here on our campus that all of these extension ministries can happen in ways that we're serving different groups. We even have now a way that you can get the content of PBC if you don't want the degree through a subscription kind of program. And so I want to shout out to Sarah Nash of TAN, our Vice President of Innovation, who has spearheaded many of those programs. And it's just given us the opportunity to serve so many more people in many places. And I know some of you are watching online, so once again, hey, if you didn't see the intro. We're so blessed here. And what we're going to do right now is I'm going to give three awards, two awards that are called the Founders Award and one that's called the Kevin Connor Award. And we got a short video here to intro this first award so you understand what it's all about.
Pastor Dick Iverson founded Portland Bible College for the purpose of preparing men and women for service in the local church and beyond. For over 50 years, the mission has been to develop leaders that are well-rounded, exemplifying Christian qualities that will make them fruitful in their calling. We're deeply grateful for the students who come to PBC with sincere passion to know and follow Christ. The accelerated growth that happens in their lives is amazing to behold. They are all worthy of honor, and to represent them, the Founders Award is given annually to two students that consistently demonstrated over 4 years of study the fruit that PBC was founded to produce. We recognize these students for modeling and exemplifying a well-rounded Christian life.
That was the voice of Lanny, isn't that cool? I just feel better when he talks, you know, it's just like. We're going to award this right now. The first student I'm going to give this to is a student that actually came from another nation and has done so well through her time here. The first one is for a female student. And she's just so exemplifies what PBC is all about and the fruit that we've been called to produce since the founding of the school. You know, which was way back in 1967. And the fruit that Pastor Iverson envisioned then, she exemplifies so well. She is a leader of leaders. She's so diligent, so faithful, so thorough, and so spiritual. And the girls in the dorm call her Mama. Mayumi! Mayumi!
Thank you.
you can tell that she is loved. Young man that we're giving the Founders Award to has been a leader on the campus from day one of his arrival here. He's such an outstanding example. And, you know, there's so many that are so outstanding, but he just kind of stands out as a leader among all of the awesome students that we have, and that is Caleb Keel. Thank you. And, he's actually become a part of our staff here, and as soon as he graduates, well, we're going to give him a couple weeks vacation, but he's actually going to be coming on staff full-time, leading our recruiting department. Yeah, so appreciate him. And now the next award, actually, we have another video clip. It's not Lanny this time, but we have another video clip explaining this one.
The heart of Manor House Church for the Nations is reflected in the students who come from all over the world to study at Portland Bible College. Comprising 20% of our student body, international students demonstrate God's heart for all people, as well as enriching and contributing greatly to the culture of our school. With over 60 nations represented among our alumni, our graduates have returned home and are making great contributions to their nations. It is our great privilege to prepare them to deeply impact their homes and the world for the cause of Christ. Named after our former dean from Australia, the Kevin Connor Award is a way in which we honour students who have travelled a great distance to be trained and equipped by God's Word. This award is given to an international student who we see as being called and prepared to have a great impact in their homeland.
Right. We had to have an Aussie voice for the Kevin Connor Award, so Kim Marie, and you know, the Aussie accent just sounds spiritual, doesn't it? Yeah, it just sounds, anyway, thank you for that. And this is a special award for us, and the person that is receiving this is somebody who is from another nation and is going back to their home nation, and we really believe they're just going to go back and have a great impact. And we just see the hand of God upon them as we do all of our international students. We honor, in giving this award, we're honoring all of our international students, like the other awards as well. We're honoring everyone. But this year, the award goes to Natalie Carroll. Yeah. All right. Okay, at this time we're going to award our bachelor's degrees. So would all those receiving bachelor's degrees, would you please stand?
Bachelor of Theology, Bridget Blinn, cum laude.
Congratulations.
Brandon Bryant, cum laude.
Come on, man. Congrats, bud. Great job. Great job.
Kirsten Burke, summa cum laude.
Congratulations. Great job.
Natalie Carroll, summa cum laude.
Congratulations. Great job.
Yoko Hino Chalk, magna cum laude.
Congratulations. Great job.
Thomas Elizondo.
Come on. Congratulations. Great job, bud.
Stephanie Escalante.
Congratulations. Great job. Great job.
Tabitha Evans, summa cum laude.
Congratulations. Great job.
Emma Geiser, summa cum laude.
Great job. Awesome.
Zax Hege, cum laude.
Hey, come on, man. Great job, bud.
Jade Hermida.
Let's go, man. Great job, bud.
Caleb Keel, summa cum laude.
go, buddy. Proud of you, man. Great job, buddy.
Mayumi Nishida, magna cum laude.
Congratulations. All the way around. Great job.
Noah Reynolds.
Come on, man. You did it, baby. Let's go, man.
Amanda Schreider.
Congratulations. Great job.
Mayara Sousa, magna cum laude.
Great job.
Jalea Taylor, magna cum laude.
Congratulations. Great job.
Drake Salimbo. Bachelor of Church Music, Kaiden Slusser, cum laude.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my great privilege to present to you the graduating class from Portland Bible College 2022. Here they are. All right. Thank you. You can be seated. At this time, we have three students that are going to come share. Just a brief word each. First is Caleb. No, Natalie's first. Nope. You go first. Okay. I thought this was all. I thought it was all prearranged, so I thought they knew.
Well, good evening, everyone. So good to be here with you guys, and thank you for asking me to speak tonight, Ken and Mark, and the rest of our team. I'm just super honored to be in front of you. If you don't know me yet, I get to know you soon, but if not, my name's Caleb. You might have heard it. And I came to PBC from a small town outside Philadelphia in Pennsylvania. And like Ken said, I've been filling the recruiting coordinator role part-time, and after graduating, I will be joining our staff full-time. So I'm really honored to be part of the PBC team now and moving forward. It's really a great honor. And I wanted to begin by saying a huge thank you to a special group of people on behalf of the graduating class, the family and friends of those graduating this evening. We're gonna just say thank you for generously supporting our students through shared meals and prayer, financially supporting us, helping us move in and out and in and out and in and out. And if parents, if that was you, you know who you are. It's a great time moving in and out of the dorms. And for so much more. So can we give it up for our friends and family of our students? You guys are amazing. Thank you. You know, as I'm leaving PBC as a student, I'm leaving with this overwhelming gratitude that for the last 4 years, I've truly felt known. You know, there are people who have seen me at my absolute worst and my absolute best and all in between, yet they still love me. They still care for me, and they still call out the good in me. And as those thoughts came to mind, those feelings of gratitude, the word that really resonated with me deeply was the word known. And so as I considered, what does it really mean to be known? And for me, the area has been somewhat of a journey that God's led me on. 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 11 helps to summarize my experience here, and it says, therefore, encourage one another and build one another up just as you are doing. You know, on this journey that I went through as a PBC student, I needed the encouragement and friendship and building up from others that I've received. But I don't think I'm alone in this desire to have this experience to be known. And so I asked myself, what's really made the difference for me? How is it possible to feel so known these last 4 years in a way that I really hadn't been able to in my whole life prior? And I realized my proximity to Christian community hadn't changed. Here at PBC, we're kind of in this little, we call it a little bubble here up on the hill. But I actually grew up in an amazing church surrounded by amazing people. And you see, actually, if I'm being honest, when I arrived at PBC, I was really shy. You can ask some of my classmates here. We go to camp right when I arrived, and I remember going to our kickoff retreat, and I was really too afraid to talk to anyone. I think I might have talked to Jade. Might have been the only person I talked to, and look at us here together. I wanted to change and experience what real relationship could look like, but I was afraid. I didn't know how to engage, and I thought that maybe if I really showed the real me, that it might not be acceptable to others. But slowly over time, I was encouraged by others reaching out and by mentors reaching out, and I want to give kind of a special shout out for the encouragement of leaders in my life, Carlos, I don't know where you are, and Annalise, I also don't know where you are, but if you're here, I love you. Thank you for encouraging me. And so what happened is a deep and authentic change began to take place in my life. What had actually changed was my commitment to growth, accountability, and seriously following Jesus became more important to me than the fear and lies of what others, even what others thought of me might be. So something happened inside of me, and all of a sudden, what the shift was is I stopped fearing man and started to fear God. That's what was going on the inside. Psalm 111, verse 10 says, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. All those who practice it have a good understanding. His praise endures forever." So I read this psalm, and I was reminded that on the other side of this process that I'd been through that we call PBC, this process of being vulnerable and being exposed, what I had gained in return was understanding that only comes from God. So today, I stand in front of you thankful, in front of my friends and family, to say that this process was worth it. Trading the fear and lies and discouragement for understanding and wisdom that comes from being fully known and fearing God rather than man. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Bridget Blinn. And I moved here 4 years ago from Central Washington, came here to attend PBC. If you knew me 4 years ago, you would have seen a lost, broken, anxious, and even suicidal girl. I want to just jump into this. 4 years ago, I remember one specific memory I have. I was in my car begging God for mercy. I was like, "God, have mercy on me. God, have mercy." So I felt like I couldn't take it anymore, and I knew I needed help. My sister Allison asked me, "Have you thought of going to PBC?" And I was like, "Okay." 3 days later, I decided to apply. So, you know, it's actually a miracle that I even came here. I think about it. I came here without a Bible. I came to Portland Bible College without a Bible. And when I was talking to one of my dorm leaders, Anna Julia, she asked me, and a group of girls actually, "You guys all have Bibles, right?" Which I still don't know what letter to ask that question, because you would assume that I would have a Bible. But I thought, you know what? Wouldn't hurt to have one. So she took me over here to this building, to the Lost and Found. And she got me a Bible in the Lost and Found across the lobby. And that's the Bible I had for a while. So, but immediately when I got here, my heart started to melt. The people here, the friends, they just started, the healing started immediately. And over time, mentors like Professor Rachel Arnold and pastors Seth and Diana Sokoloff really helped me fight that battle. So I just want to take a quick moment to thank the Manor House pastors and leaders for just showing what true biblical leadership looks like. And I want to thank the professors for pouring out their heart and soul into the classes and into the students. Guys, the relationships you guys have built with us will make a lifelong impact and will continue to make a lifelong impact year after year. So let's give it up for them really quick, really quick. And guys, I look back, and in this moment, I realize God did answer my prayer 4 years ago when I asked Him, when I asked God to have mercy on me. I came here a lost and broken person, and I'm leaving PBC healed, whole, and so grateful for what God has done through this school. Anyways, that is it. Thank you very much.
I'm gonna change a little bit and read for you if that's okay. My name is Mayara. I've been an online student here at PBC since 2016. It's an honor to be standing here today. Although this is my first time stepping into this building, I have felt very much a part of this community since day one when I first hit play to watch Basic Doctrines class. I remember sitting in my living room in Atlanta, Georgia at the time with my newborn daughter looking at me. Now, 6 years later, I can say that every lecture after that was as enriching and challenging. When I first started pursuing my bachelor's degree at PBC, I would often count the credits and try to figure out how many years it would take me to finish. But when I realized the process to completion had so much more to do with my spiritual and personal growth than obtaining a degree, I was really able to make the most of this unique journey I was on. Of course, I did not stop counting the credits, for they matter too. Otherwise, we wouldn't be here today. I have taken every class during summer, and I also even added a few classes from the online Portuguese campus, which, by the way, I want to take a moment and thank the team in Brazil working so hard to make this possible, to all the Portuguese speakers. It's been amazing. I'm grateful for the flexibility of the online program, where I could literally take this amazing faculty with me wherever I went. I was able to keep taking courses when my husband's job moved us from Atlanta to Boston, and when my secondborn came along. I remember trying to do all the assignments done before the baby's due date, which was near Thanksgiving break. But online students don't get breaks. Once the clock starts for those 14 weeks, we don't stop. So I just want to say that I loved learning from the unique perspective from each teacher, watching the lectures that were so nerdy that would sometimes make my brain hurt, the sociological perspective brought up by some of the teachers, even the international and political influences pointed out by others. And at the same time, it all tied to this beautiful picture that God has been painting that involves all of us shining his light wherever we are. My fellow graduates also deserve a shout out. Even though I've never met in person, I can tell they're incredible people from all around the world, connected and pouring into each other's lives. I got to share so many prayer requests with them, including a little bit of our journey of becoming foster parents. It's now an honor to be standing here tonight, remembering that all through the transitions, the joys, the tears, God has been faithful. It's also an honor to celebrate with this amazing team, students, and alumni, and to say to all of you in person now, and not through my computer screen, thank you. Congratulations, PBC students.
Well, good evening. It's great to see everybody here. I do want to first and foremost thank the parents for entrusting us with your kids. I know that that is a huge deal to send your kids off to a college, and we're so grateful that you entrusted your beautiful, precious kids to us. We want to thank you so much for that. And I want to congratulate this group. My goodness. What a great, great group of students. As Ken already talked about, you know, this lesson, if you don't mind me going back and forth, I would appreciate that. I want to talk to this beautiful group of people. Congratulations. You know, it's been an incredibly unusual season. And I believe that God has brought you in this particular season in an unusual time because there's an unusual call upon your life. And I believe that God's brought his best here, and I think that every class has its unique specialties and greatness to it. But again, you came in one of the most significant, challenging times in the history of our lifetime. And I believe that God has something very special in store for each of you. And so excited to be able to just talk to you just for a minute or two in regards to just this special thought that I had for you. And I want to talk to you about this thought. Our heritage is you.
Our heritage is you. And you've been here long enough to know that this arrow or an arrow is really symbolic of your life. And in the natural, we recognize that an arrow is used by a warrior, and that arrow, as it sits in a quiver, is something that brings confidence. And the warrior knows that the arrow itself has, he's handpicked these arrows, and he's made sure that they were balanced and the tip was sharp and that it was ready for use, and that as he would go out or she would go out into battle, that there was an added confidence because of what was in their quiver. And in the spiritual, the same applies. As we think about you, you've come here, just like was so eloquently shared by some of our speakers, and you came here to be shaped and to be molded and to be sharpened, and you've been well crafted. And we have such great confidence in knowing that you are a quiver, or you're in the quiver, and it's full of some very, very well ready arrows to be shot out. Can I hear an amen? Amen. Come on, you guys can say amen. I'm talking about you guys. And so I want to read a scripture. And again, this is a scripture that is familiar, and it's often applied with natural parents and their charge to raise their children well. And obviously for you that are parents, this scripture still directly applies, but it also applies to the faculty and to us pastors and leaders as spiritual parents. And you know, we've poured our life into you, we've prayed with you, we've cried with you, we've laughed with you. It's been a beautiful journey as we've come together. And I believe that this scripture really capsulizes the thought that I would have for you. And in Psalm 27, 1 through 5, this is a short psalm written by King Solomon. There's only five verses here, and it's one of the 15 Psalms of Ascents, and it was something that the children of Israel would rehearse on their way up to Jerusalem during the few festivals. And there was this moment in time where they would rehearse and remember some significant thoughts. And I want to just challenge you with this psalm for you, this graduating class, because I think there's some nuggets in it in this unique season that I think that would be worthy of attention and for you to take away with you. But it says this, it says, "Unless the Lord builds the house, those who build it labor in vain. And unless the Lord watches over the city, the watchmen stay awake in vain. It is in vain that you rise up early and go late to rest, and eating the bread of anxious toil, for he gives to his beloved sleep." And this is really where I want to focus, is that behold, children are a heritage from the Lord, the fruit of the womb a reward, like arrows in the hand of a warrior are the children of one's youth. Blessed is the man who fills his quiver with them. Amen. For he shall not be put to shame when he speaks with his enemies at the gate. And I just have five simple charges for you as we look at this scripture, and just some thoughts that I'd like you to really put in your seed bag that I think would be critical for your life in the days ahead. And the first thought is this, is make sure that Jesus is the center of it all. And you look at this portion of scripture in verse 1, Solomon says, unless, there's a condition, he says, unless the Lord builds. And he goes on and he says that those that don't, they labor in vain. And he's trying to bring up these two ideologies that I believe will confront you and is already confronting you in the life in which you live and will get increasingly intense on the way out. And that's a biblical worldview, and that's a secular worldview. And there's going to be pressures that come your way, and there's going to be temptations and challenges that are going to war for your destiny and your purpose. And I want to encourage you as you leave here today to make Jesus the center of your everything, of your life, of your marriage, of your parenting, of your career, of your ministry. And I know that sounds really simplistic, but unless he builds your life, unless he is at the center of everything that you do, you will labor in vain. And here's the second thought that I get out of this scripture that I believe is for you tonight, is make his house the center of your aim. And Solomon says, unless the Lord builds the house. And again, a lot of commentators would suggest the idea that he was talking about building the temple. And although this can apply to the natural home, and obviously it does, we see in his life that he dedicated so much of his time and energy in building the temple. And when you look at your life, again, regardless of what you do, whether you go into full-time ministry or career, whether you're going to be a stay-at-home mom, whatever you're going to do with your life, you've got to make sure that you give your life, your heart, to the local church. We often say that Jesus and the local church is the hope of the world. Never get distracted from it. Protect it, love it, serve, be a part of it. And make sure not only that Jesus is the center of it all, but that you give your life, regardless of where you're at in your journey, to build the local church. The world today needs strong, thriving, vibrant local churches, and we believe that you're being shot out into those local churches to be a strength and to make sure that there's a right ecclesiology out there for everybody that surrounds us. The third thing is this, is that you are our heritage. I love this statement because I envision this being said between parents and kids on the journey, so to speak. And there's these words that stick out in this verse 3. It says, behold, children are a heritage from the Lord, the fruit of the womb, a reward. And this word, behold, hinnah, it actually means this. It says, look now, give your immediate attention. Like, don't get distracted. Like, grab a hold of this thought. And this is really where I want to speak into your heart tonight, is this word heritage means valuable inheritance given by one person to a successive generation. And this is really important, is that you're just not graduating, but there's actually a divine exchange that takes place, that will take place in your generation, is that you are getting the baton of the local church and the history and the heritage of the kingdom of God, and to never take that for granted, that you keep your attention on your call and your purpose and your destiny, and you make sure whatever it takes to not treat that as common, because it's a precious thing. And I want to just encourage you with that, is that not only is this a heritage that you should just protect, but we are counting on you. Like, I'm bald and 61. I mean, it's just like life goes fast. I don't know how old Ken is. He still's got a hair a lot better looking than me, but I'm just telling you, listen, life goes fast, and we are trusting in you. You are our pride. You are our joy. You are our heritage. Here's the fourth thing that I just want to share with you, is that you are our arrows. You're our arrows. And in Psalm 127, 4, it says, like arrows in the hand of a warrior. It goes on and says, so are the children of one's youth. And we look at you as arrows. And the arrow to us, it represents a couple different things. We look at the tip of the arrowhead, and it really represents your education and your skills. And hopefully you've come here to be sharpened in your education, your gifting, your skills. We want to make sure wherever that you go that you have penetration and force into darkness and into complex situations. The shaft really represents your character. And you've heard it over and over and over again, is that your character will always supersede your gifting. And so many of you came here with crooked shafts, if you will, and broken and fractured and fragile shafts, and we would always rather have a straight shaft with a dull tip than a sharp tip with a crooked shaft, because your character will always take you in life wherever you go. And then also just these beautiful feathers, the three different areas, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Without God working in your life, if you shoot an arrow without any of those feathers, It just falls. It goes crooked. And I believe that in this day and this hour that Jesus has got you in his hand and that you've been educated, you've got great character, you've got the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit with you, and you are going to be shot very well and far to go do great things for God. And my last thought is just this, is that you're our blessing. You know, I was just so moved with some of the stories up here and just things that were shared from your journey and your life. And there's no greater joy than we have than to see you finishing your course with joy. And the scripture says in verse 5, blessed or blessed is the man. Blessed is the parents. Blessed is the faculty. Blessed is your friends. Everybody looking at you. You guys are absolutely amazing. And it just goes on and it says that blessed is the man who's fills his quiver with them, and he shall not be put to shame when he speaks with his enemies in the gate. We're so proud of you. We love you so much. We're so grateful that you came. And we count it a joy. History will only tell the story of the great things that God will do in your life. And I just want to say thank you. We're blessed, we're honored that you're in our life. Come on, would you put your hands together one more time for this beautiful staff?
Thank you. Wow. Thank you, Pastor Mark. So meaningful, the words. The whole arrow analogy is something that the Lord has spoken prophetically over our college, and it's been through a couple of decades, actually, in different ways. And that's how we've kind of landed on that as kind of the main symbol of what God has called us to do here. So now we're going to do something pretty unusual for a graduation. One more thing before we're done tonight. And I'm going to ask the faculty and staff to all come to the stage. I'm going to ask all of our graduates to stand. And for those of you receiving the four-year degree, we have an arrow engraved, your name on it, etc. And we're going to hand you each an arrow that is symbolic of the work that we see God doing in and through your lives that is only just beginning. And we're going to gather around you, and we're going to lay hands on you, and we're going to pray. Pastor Mark's going to lead us in prayer, but we're going to make sure each one of you have your arrow first. And I think we have some way to kind of cover the sharp tip there, so we're going to be safe with this. But I'm going to wait till we get our whole staff up here. Just keep coming. And we're going to gather clear around. Yeah, keep coming. So one's behind. Thank you. And we're going to have a special prayer. This is kind of our way of not only celebrating the award of their academic degree, but to view this as a spiritual commissioning. And so I'm going to ask all of you to stand, and you're going to join in with us in this prayer, because I know you care about the people that are up here, and some of you have just have invested so much. And I'm going to ask Pastor Mark to come. We're going to lay hands on them and pray. I want you just to kind of stretch your hand towards them as though you get to be here as well, imparting to them. And we're going to believe that the Lord is going to impart great grace upon them as they are commissioned from this time and place forward.
Lord, we come before you tonight, and Lord, recognize that this is truly a sacred, holy moment. Lord, we believe that this is a spiritual moment. And Lord, as we lay our hands on these beautiful graduates, Lord, as those that are online even are extending their hands, and everybody in this opportunity, God, we believe in divine exchange. And Lord, we just come and acknowledge, Lord, just their great work, their effort, God, their growth. Lord, we also recognize that it was a means to an end. It was not an end in itself, that
this journey was not about a degree, but we're thankful for the degree. Lord, this is about placement. This is about assignment. This is about a journey. And Lord, we come today, God, as we lay hands on these students. And Lord, we commission them in the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, we lay our hands on them, and we are praying right now that you would come and you would bless them. Lord, that you would protect them. Lord, that you would guide them. You would direct their steps. Lord, that you would just make sure, Father, that they would not turn to the left or the right, but Lord, they would set their eyes, set their sight on, God, their purpose and the call of God upon their life. And Lord, we pray for a fresh anointing. God, we know that they're going into a world that is broken and divided and hurting. And we pray for faith. We pray for authority. God, we pray for a special grace, God, that you would put them in unusual places to do unusual things for you, God. You send them into every sphere of society. Lord, let them be light. Let them be salt. Let the end result, Father, of their journey here, God, and this commissioning be, Lord, that your kingdom is extended. So we come tonight and we thank you for them. We bless them. God, we commission them in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Come on, and everybody said, amen, amen.
Yes, amen. Let's thank the Lord. Amen. Thank you. Amen. All right, we're going to remain standing up here, but I'm going to ask you to be seated just for one more minute. The last thing we're going to do here is I'm going to have the faculty and staff make their way back to their seats. And we have planned a reception to follow this, and it's you go out the doors behind, right at the back of the auditorium here, and you go straight across the hallway, and there's doors leading up to what we call Ivy Hall, a gymnasium just across the way. And we're set up there for a reception. There's a photo place, et cetera. And so first, though, we're going to have a recessional. So we're going to have the faculty and staff followed by the students. And we'll all file out like we came in. And then we'll meet you over there in Ivy Hall. And when everybody's gone, then feel free to be dismissed and join us across the hall. Thank you so much for coming tonight. God bless you. Let's give the Lord one more hand for what he's done tonight. Amen. And for all these graduates.